cannot keep a casting secret. First, Brie Larson, now Donald Glover. But, oh, it's so fantastic. We don't have to worry about it anymore. It's happened. It's official. Donald Glover is indeed, just like Brie Larson is Carol Danvers, Lando Calrissian. And he's going to make his debut as the younger version of the character in the upcoming Han Solo origin movie. Actually, not the younger version of the character. The same version that was seen in the original Star Wars movie, Episode 4. They've just cast different actors in the roles because, well, of the obvious. And the casting is so amazing. Donald Glover in this role, because he not only embodies the vibe of Billy Dee Williams, but actually looks like him, that I think it's going to make it even harder for Alden Ehrenreich, poor Alden Ehrenreich, to convince us that he is Harrison Ford's Han Solo. Because we're going to look at Donald Glover and be like, it's Billy Dee! And then we're going to go look at Alden Ehrenreich and go, that is clearly not Harrison Ford. And I think that because of this casting, Alden Ehrenreich should be very afraid it's going to turn into the Lando Calrissian movie, which I don't necessarily think would be a horrible thing, but it's going to be an uphill battle for poor Alden Ehrenreich. I still think they should have cast Taron Egerton. There's some debate as to whether or not he was ever up for the role. He said he didn't know if he wanted it. Again, if I were Disney, I would have hounded him and stalked him and said, what is it going to take to make you Han Solo? Because I think he is very similar in his vibe and look to Harrison Ford. I would have gone maybe with Ansel Elgort, or maybe even Jack Raynor, who had the stink of Transformers on him, like, you know, like the lame secondary guy role, not the lead like Mark Wahlberg, right? Or back in the day before all hell broke loose, Shia LaBeouf. Because Jack Raynor, I feel so bad for Alden Ehrenreich. Okay, so Jack Raynor got a lot of praise for his turn in Sing Street, so it seems that maybe he's not a horrible actor after all. But anyway, I'm not saying that Alden Ehrenreich isn't talented. I'm sure many of you are already in the comment section being like, why are you so mean to Alden Ehrenreich? Give him a chance. Should he start a support group with Joe Manganiello? I don't think that Alden Ehrenreich is on the same level as Joe Manganiello. Who I'm again open to proving me wrong, but when it comes to Alden Ehrenreich, he just doesn't have the charisma, the star power that radiates off of Donald Glover. And because this role is so perfectly cast, that charisma is going to go supernova when he becomes the new Lando Calrissian. Also, I'd like to point out that it's just a fact, there's a really strong masculinity to Harrison Ford and Billy Dee Williams that Donald Glover, I think, also has. And it shows. You can have a different body type and still radiate that masculinity. But Alden Ehrenreich, I don't see him doing that. That's why Taron Egerton, Ansel Elgort, Jack Raynor, I think they could have pulled off, you know, the slit shirt, the leather vest, right? I think Alden Ehrenreich's just not going to be able to do it. Now, I want to talk about the importance of this role in the casting, because I also, as bad as I feel for Alden Ehrenreich, I also feel a little bad for Billy Dee Williams. I think this has to sting a little bit, because he, of course, originated the role. He obviously can't return to it, but he originated it in a very different time in Hollywood, where it was a big deal that he got this tiny little role in Star Wars, right? So to see it blow up in this way, and potentially, you know, overshadow Han Solo, it kind of sucks that Billy Dee Williams isn't going to be able to get the benefit of that, right? So I hope that Lucasfilm does right by him and gives him a cameo in the new movie. Just to, you know, I don't, like, show the man some respect. Now, also speaking of casting, I think this is fascinating in light of all the discussions we've been having lately about colorblind casting, changing the ethnicity of a well-known, or maybe sometimes not even well-known character, right? That's been a big, you know, debate subject as of late in the fanboy and fangirl community. Now, here's a character who, a cool character who started out a character of color, but because of the time period that the movie was made, he was relegated to the sidelines. But now he's being brought front and center in a way that really re-energizes the character, and this might prove to be the most effective after all. Perhaps, you know, maybe colorblind casting got the ball rolling, right? But maybe this is the way to go after all. When everybody said, get characters that were originally of color or create new characters originally of color, there might, maybe indeed that is the ideal situation. Because I think that's going to make this more potent. I think there's a legacy to, you know, to the Lando Calrissian character, because he was one of the first, if not, I think the first black character in a major mainstream franchise. So that's just absolutely amazing. It's a big deal for Donald Glover. So again, unless the role, his role is smaller than Ehrenreich's, and I don't think that would be a good idea, because again, it would just mean that Star Wars was relegating a character of color to the sidelines. And they kind of did that in The Force Awakens already. So I don't think they want to do that with Lando. So I think it's going to end up being his movie. Because Donald Glover is such an incredibly skilled comedian. So is Ehrenreich. But think of all, because, you know, Hail Caesar. But think of all the gifs that Community with Donald Glover has spawned, right? I mean, the guy's really good at physical comedy. And then he's going to team up with Phil Lord and Chris Miller, who did amazing work and helped the career, you know, shape the comedy careers of Channing Tatum, Chris Pratt, and even Liam Neeson. They just, you know, they really, I think, can do a very good job with talent. And I love the first thing that they said in their statement, saying, also, we'd like to publicly apologize to Donald for ruining Comic-Con for him forever. I thought that was a really nice, charming touch. And speaking of Comic-Con, the Lando cosplay is going to be out of control, and it's going to be amazing, right? Because, you know, I think there were a lot of Miles's, but you know what discouraged people from being Miles Morales was that, you know, you have to have the mask. But come on, you get to be Lando. His costume is amazing, and as Lord and Miller pointed out, he's got the cape. Ooh, so that means whoever wins the cape off between Darth Vader and Orson Krennic in Rogue One will have to go up against Lando for the next round. And they're all in the same time period, don't forget, because Rogue One takes place right before Episode 4, and Lando was around during Episode 4, but debuted in the series in Episode 5. I also think it's worth noting that maybe Donald Glover is becoming a Disney player, because he's also in Spider-Man Homecoming. He didn't get to be Spider-Man, but I think this is a lot better, because again, it's organic, and I think it might end up being all the more powerful for it. Now, finally, the note I want to end on is, will he continue to do Atlanta, right? That's a show that just got started, tremendous buzz, but this is a game changer for in many ways, not just for the movie industry and for big blockbuster films and for Star Wars, but also for Donald Glover. So my guess is that he'll, of course, finish, you know, they've already finished the season. He'll do Atlanta, win some Emmys and Golden Globes, right? Because the buzz, again, very good. And then I think that he, if Lando is well received, if it really does go as well as I think it will, he'll fully make the jump to movies. Which is not to say that Atlanta will end. It has an amazing cast and also a behind-the-camera team that has gotten a lot of attention. So I think that Donald Glover, I think the smart play would be to phase himself out of the show as an on-camera talent, stick around as a producer or executive producer, maybe come back for a cameo here and there, and pass the baton to some other talent and let them make a name for themselves and maybe have an opportunity one day to join a big franchise as well. So what do you think of this casting? Do you think that Alden Ehrenreich can compete? And do you think that Donald Glover will nail this role as much as I think that he will? And what do you think should happen with Atlanta? Write your thoughts down below, and you can check out some more videos right now.